Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube, and I received a track plan that a viewer asked me to review. This video, I'm going to give my personal opinion. Now, the first thing I always ask when people talk about building a layout is, what do you want to model and why? He said he wanted to model the 1950s, he loves the steam and to the early diesel, and the location has some sentimental value to him. So it's going to be the Midwest. All right. This is a personal video based upon my experience as an engineer for the past 25 years with CSX. I've driven trains in Pennsylvania, Ohio, Maryland, and West Virginia, 1,000 miles of territory. I've been on fast main lines to industrial tracks, so many different yards, so many different industries. This is just going to be my opinion. You do whatever you want. I just hope in this video, watch the whole thing, because you might say, okay, you know what, I like this what he said, I didn't really like that. Kind of cherry pick. You don't have to do everything I say. I don't want you to be me or to do exactly what I do. I just simply want you to take what works for you. Okay? All right, so with this track plan, this is quite a few years old. The first thing that I said, what do you want to see when you come into a train room? Now, personally, I always model where I grew up and areas around me. That's sentimental to me. And with this, he says, when he walks into a train room, he wants to see the peninsula. So I see where he comes in. The peninsula. The one thing, probably my biggest critique about this whole layout, and I see this in a lot of layouts, is putting the track right against the edge. That's a major pet peeve of mine. Yes, in some cases, you know, you have no choice. But when you have the option to add even just a few inches of scenery before the track, it's going to be a game changer, because now you're not watching the trains go outside a layout. You're watching the trains cut through the town, cut through the scenery. It makes it feel like the railroad had a purpose, that it, you know, when they designed it in the prototype, it's like, we got to get from here to here, and there's no other way. We got to build a bridge, we got to build a tunnel, we got to cut through here. And that's what I think that you should try to emulate when modeling. So with the peninsula, it is a curve. He'd like to see a couple trestles, and I'm cool with that. I would suggest in areas, of course, you want to give yourself some aisle space, because we're not getting any thinner, most of us. So there's going to be some areas we're going to have to cut it as close so that you can squeeze through. But on some other areas, add a few more inches of bench work. You don't have to make the exact same perfect circle. Make a shape that's going to allow some foreground scenery. Okay, yards. This is always the biggest pet peeve of mine. I don't think people have really understood the purpose of a yard. And I have so many videos about prototype operations and track planning where I explain about yards. I've shown with the drone so many different yards. A yard. Now, of course, I've covered staging yards, yes, and I've covered, storage yards, that type of stuff. But for the most part, a yard is a place where all the cars from the local industry are brought back to the yard. And it's like, okay, so these cars are going to, they need to be put on track A, because all of our track A cars are going to be picked up by a main line to take over this way. Same thing with our cars on track B. They're going to go that way. And it's for organizing. And so, like where I work, I get mad if I see cars in the yard that have nothing to do with the local industry. It's like, why are we, you know, we have like, I'm in Pittsburgh, and in our area, it's very industrial. So there's going to be stuff for steel mills and for local industries and chemical plants. So there should be no auto racks stored in the yard. And there are. Okay. Pet peeve. So in the same thing, the yard should have the cars for all the industries that are on this layout. And I don't see a lot of industries on this layout. So the yard doesn't have to be that big. So I would say downsize this yard. Each track, I'm just going to just go with N scale for this layout. Each track, if this was N scale, would probably hold, I don't know, 10 to 12, maybe even more cars. I don't see an industry that can handle enough industries to handle this stuff. So I would dramatically reduce the size of this yard. Now, he wants to model steam. And so I see where he has the coaling tower and the ash pit and the engine house. So often with this, I see this is simply designed from, okay, I have bench work. What can I fill the bench work with? Get rid of that mentality. Get rid of that mentality that you have to fill the bench work with track. Got to fill it with track. Here's some space. Let me throw some track over here. That's what sucks. Sorry about that, but that's true. Instead, think of it from a railroader's point of view. When we come to work, and we come to the yard office, we get our paperwork, we get all of our orders, we want to be able to walk out of the yard office and right onto our engines. And so, and then from there, we would take the engines and go to the yard and do our work. That doesn't seem, I don't even see like a yard office. You gotta start modeling yard offices, and I have videos on how to make them and what they're for. So start thinking that way. Start thinking of a real railroad. Have parking for the employees. Have the yard office. Have the road that goes to it. Another thing, I don't see a single road on this. This kind of drives me nuts. Okay, sorry. So have the engine house, the coaling tower, the ash pit closer together. Start looking at some prototype maps to see that this stuff is organized. And then I would say that should be closer towards the ladder of the yard. This seems kind of reverse. I also see, let's just say this main line is a 40 mile an hour main line. I don't like the fact that if someone forgot to line a switch back instead of for straightaway movement, that a train can go 40 miles an hour into an ash pit or an engine house. So I would get those away from the main line. Okay, let's see. Other things about this layout. Like I said, there's no room for scenery. Less is more. In the 50s, yeah, double track was way more common than it is today because of the signal system, CTC, that's we can have signals going in both directions. We've been able to downsize from double track down to single track, maybe some passing sidings. And of course, once the automobile and the trucks came out and the highway system, things left the railroads and went onto highways. So that's why the railroads were able to downsize. All right, but once he did the 50s, yeah, I can understand why he'd want to have some double track. Okay, so let's take a look at Kansas City over here. I believe that's what he's looking at, Kansas City. The ferry slip, okay. Well, that's cool, but I'm not seeing where there's water. There's too much track and not enough scenery. So I would redesign that. Okay, another pet peeve is these coal mines. I've done videos about this. Maybe I'll have a link or something in this video. Coal mines. I've worked areas with coal mines, loading coal and power plants, and we do not go one car, drop it off, leave it there, or you know, fill it up and leave, go back, keep doing this one car at a time. No. You pull a train through the coal mine. You pull it through the loader. In most cases, I don't see stub-ended. Because we don't want to load one car at a time. You're going to pull through. And loading coal, unloading coal at power plants is less than 1 mile per hour. It is the slowest, most boring job. It really is boring. We would unload a 90-car coal train at a power plant, and it would take every bit of 8 hours to do it because it is that slow. And just sitting there as an engineer, doing less than, in some cases, it was like 0.04 mile per hour. I mean, it was awful. So the coal mines, I would say just get rid of that altogether. Another huge pet peeve I have is if you look at the brewery. So why did the brewery put it at the very, very, very far end of that track? And I mean, I don't see any access roads. I see no reason. And that to me just once again looks like I have space. Let me just put something here. If anything, keep your industry, your sidings as close to the main line as possible. You got to remember, the train will come up. Let's say that a brewery car is the head out or first car right behind the engine. We would stop. We would tie the handbrakes on the train that we're leaving on the main line. And then we would pull up. Now the conductor has to ride the side of the car. He has to ride the side of the car. And unless he can, you know, can walk. As he backs it to spot it at the brewery. He's going to be mad that the brewery is so, the further you keep making these leads all the way down just to stop at the very last spot, it's not fun for the conductor to hold on. Like, man, why is this here? Why didn't we rearrange the track? So stop putting your industries at the very end, because I just feel like this is someone saying, I want to have as much track. I want to see as much track as possible. And that is not how the railroads work, because tracks require maintenance. The more track, more chance you're going to derail. So keep it simple. All right, going over to Colorado Springs. He said, you know what? We can lose the passenger aspect of it. I would agree with that. He wants to do more Midwest. So if anything, I would rearrange some track to have more silos. I'm seeing the stock pen as being the only industry between the edge of the layout and the edge of the layout and the track. That still seems squeezed in there. So much of this just seems so squeezed and so forced. So here's my suggestions: is we would completely redesign the yard. We would actually widen that to have more scenery. We would redesign the brewery, like that area. We'd get rid of the coal mine. We would add more bench work for the ferry slip and for the creamery, and we would design this with towns. I don't know where this is, and that is huge for me. Even if you're making a generic area, I want to feel the town. There's a town there. There's a reason there for the railroad. It's not just, hey, here's the middle of nowhere. Here's track, and there's an industry. I don't know how the people get there. I don't know when they get off work, where they go, because there's nothing else around. There's no banks, there's no stores, there's no restaurants, there's no gas stations. I'm not seeing room on this layout for anything other than industries. And that takes away the feel of railroading. So I'm going to see what I can do to maybe try to redraw some of this. And now please don't go emailing me with your layouts. This is like a one-off. I just don't have the time. Now my Patreons, I try to answer their questions first, but I just don't have the time to go through everyone's track plan. So please don't send it to me. This was just kind of, like I said, a one-off. And hopefully this gives you some ideas. You could take all my ideas and throw them in the garbage can. I don't know. You could like everything I say. It doesn't matter. As long as you take what works for you. I'm just hoping that my experience shows you how the real railroad works. Remember, those track planning books that came out way back in the day, we all had those Atlas SnapTrack books, that was to sell track. All those figure eights, up and overs, all that stuff was simply to sell more track. Yeah, they would do it to like squeeze as much track into a 4x8. Remember all that? That wasn't how railroads look. It was just to make money. my philosophy is I don't want to see you guys go broke by buying so much track, not finishing a layout. A lot of times people try to make layouts that are just too big. They try to tackle their first layout as a full basement empire and it gets to be overwhelming and they quit. I want you to stay in the hobby. If you're a kid, you don't have a lot of money, then don't go out buying a lot of tracks. Start small. If you're a senior on a fixed income, I hear a lot about that. Don't go spending a lot of money trying to make some basement empire when honestly, you just want to make something that you're going to enjoy. And I hope this video helps with that. And I thank you for watching. So I got more videos coming and let's see what I come up with. That was long-winded, wasn't it? Jeez. So here's what I came up with. Now let's look at the upper left. I put grain silos up there. I have foreground scenery, which would be some houses. I have a road to access the grain silos. There are still two red mainline tracks. And purple, we have like an industrial track and the unloading track. And that's pretty prototypical. I think people don't realize that we work off the main. Once again, we work off of the main. We will leave our train on the main line, cut away, go in with just the engines to pick up cars, or we would, you know, cut behind our set off and put those over onto the industrial track. Grain silos usually have just like a, I don't want to say forklift, I'm forgetting what they're called, just to move the cars around. Sometimes I've seen some grain silos, they have like those little tiny 44 tonners or those little tiny car movers just to move the cars around. Okay, so then we have a crossover that takes us from one main line to another, and then we'll come down. I forgot to mention this earlier, but we need an interchange because all railroads interchange with other railroads, and so we're going to have one here. So take a look at the interchange. Now, I've tried to show a different railroad with a mix of, I don't know if you could tell or not, but it's kind of like a red and blue type mainline track. And that interchange is so simple. If you could see, basically, you'll leave the cars there, and then the other railroad will just pick them up and vice versa. Interchanges are very simple. I've done plenty of videos on them, and they are simple just like that. All right, so more of the peninsula. He wanted to have a bridge, a trestle scene. Well, you got to remember, he wanted some water features over, you know, you can't have a car float without water. So I made the river on this side into the peninsula. He wanted a lumber, and that is pretty similar to how most lumber companies in my area are. They just have a track that kind of goes off, and it's between buildings like this. I just went off of a lot of prototypes I've seen. Once again, check out some of my videos, and you'll see from the drone, that's what they look like. So we went from double track to single track through a single truss bridge, and then over a lift out. And I left some space. I personally like the Cotto. There's a Cotto track that you can kind of like slide back and forth. You know, it's adjustable. And I like to always have those so that you can make a lift out track and it's easier to work that way. So then onto the right hand side, he wanted the pier and like a car float. Well, so we have the car float. We have the river, which makes sense because we have river on the other side. And then we have industrial buildings because you want to have that industrial look. It's not going to be a car float in the middle of nowhere. It's going to be near the industrial areas. I left room for parking. I left some additional tracks. You know, you can do whatever you want. But that's my thought process on what I came up with for the, I'll just say, the lower part. Okay, now for the upper part, we still have the double track main line. If we go to the upper left, we have crossovers that take you from one side of the, or one main line to the other, and then a switch onto the, we'll call it the siding. Remember, your sidings and all your yard tracks are going to be 10 miles per hour. Okay, so you come into the siding, and the first thing you'd come to is where all the engine facilities are going to be. Now, he wants to model steam, so we still have the engine house. We have the ash at the far end and the coaling tower prior.
We have an access road because you got to get to these places. And then on the other side of the road is the yard office. And the yard office is right next to the yard lead because the conductor, he gets his paperwork, his switch list, and he just walks up and down that yard lead lining the different switches. Gotta think like the real railroads. Okay, so the first track in the yard, we're just going to call that like a runaround track. That's honestly what we call it. We call it the runaround. And so he can leave his eastbound cars there. Or that's pretty much what we would do, is we would switch with the engine on the west end, get our cars ready. And if we are going to go west, we'll just take the whole, you know, the whole train west. But if we got to go east, we'll put those cars into, you see how I put the two little black marks there on that runaround. We'll put those cars there, run around them, and take the train east. That's how locals work. So I just made a simple three-track yard. I don't know if he wants to make it shorter or longer. So one track is going to be for your interchange cars. And also on there will be your lumber cars and your grain cars. The second track, that's where you'd probably keep your ferry cars and other industries that he may add to this layout. And then you have another track, and that's going to help just having some room to switch with. And then, on the siding, you also have the water tower. And then I just made some other buildings back there for, you know, like a mechanical buildings and shop buildings and whatever. Put a restaurant in there. I don't care. And then I have the main line as far away from the front of the layout. You're going to put a forest there. You don't want to always see your track. Once again, you don't always want to see your track. I'm not a big fan of mountains, but I am a fan of putting tall foreground scenery just to hide the train periodically. So I hope this helps. I hope this gives you some ideas of just how I think and how the real railroads work. And I appreciate all your support. And I have more videos coming up. So thank you. And I'll talk to you soon. Bye.